the main people. Our assets are not our buildings, our roads, our factories, our universities and other institutions which we see. The greatest assets are the people, because it's the people who make those things happen. So that's why investing in people is the best investment which every government, including our government, can make. And also the best investments that each individual or a parent can make in the future of their children and themselves. So this is basically a guideline for us in the government to make sure that our population are the best educated and the best trained people in the world. And if we are going to compete around the world in terms of economy, we can only compete, as I sometimes refer to the fact that I say, you know, we cannot compete in the world stage and rely on our muscles, and we have to rely on our brains. And that comes from education. So, as Minister for Training Colleges and Universities, since 2014 election, when they briefed me about OSAP, I found it very difficult to navigate in this system. OSAP is a very, very complicated, complex system. So, as I said in my interview with the Globe and Mail, I said, you know, for me, a person with four university degrees, I found it very hard to navigate OSAP. So I thought, how an ordinary person or a young person coming out of high school can navigate this system? It's almost impossible. And the other point or other major problem which I noticed in OSAP was that the grants which is given to students, or loan which is given to students, the students, they get these loans and grants towards end of their, after a year or after a year and a half. For example, tax credit for tuition and education tax credit, which people received and still do. It comes a year and a half after the person enters their college or university, and that is basically buried in the very very complicated our income tax return form. So people really don't see it, and if they didn't get it, it's buried in so many things, so people don't feel it. The result, I asked, I said, how many students coming from low-income families, they participate in post-secondary education? Or in other words, how many percentage of people coming from low-income families enter to university or college? The number, well, the stat was 22%. And how many percentage of students going to university or college coming from affluent families? The number was 77%. Huge gap, huge gap. So I said, we have to break this barrier. We have to break this barrier. And we start working on it with my colleagues at the Ministry of Finance. So we came up with this new huge, very significant and important reformation of OSAP system, student assistance system. So based on the new system, students coming from from families of $50,000 income or less, tuition practically will be free for them. And the students coming from, and this will be about 150,000 students, by the way. 150,000 students, almost one quarter of our students. We have around 650,000 students in our universities and colleges. So 50,000 of them will enjoy free education. Yesterday I was attending a meeting with our Aboriginal leaders, and when I mentioned this to them, and of course they knew, so one of them told me, she said, Minister, all our young people, they come from that kind of families. So it's going to help our communities enormously, because all our students now will enjoy free education. Breaking that barrier, I think, is one of the major achievements of our government, and it's a very historic, in fact, in the history of this province, not only this province in Canada as well. I believe Ontario is the only and the first province to come up with this very important and significant step towards making post-secondary education free for that category of people, and making equal opportunity for everyone in this province. So no student in this province can have an excuse that I can't continue my education. If that person is willing, is able to continue her or his education in college or university, education will be free for them. But in the meantime, we have also done a couple of other things. How long can I go?
I used to be quiet.
Yeah, she used to be publisher and I used to be a university professor, so I can keep going.
Wrap it up.
All right. So what I was saying that, yeah, we have done a few other things as well in relation to modernization of OSA, and one of them is we have removed the barrier for graduate for students who have been graduated from high school more than 4 years. Under the current system, they are not eligible to tap into OSA. So if you graduate, for example, 4 years and 1 month earlier from high school, you can use OSA. But we have removed that barrier. So if a person graduated 6 years ago from high school or 10 years ago from high school, now decides to go to university or college, can tap into OSA. And the same is true, the barriers we removed for married students and for mature students. So these are some of the things we have done in this new modernization of the OSAP system, which is going to have enormous impact in our in educating our public, our students and our young people. So, Madam Chair.
Thank you very much, Minister Moretti, and thank you so much for spending my 5 minutes.